Good day, class, and welcome to another lecture in Engineering Unit 1. Today, we will discuss the electrical auxiliary systems or the electronic systems. Once again, I am your instructor. I'm Architect Seth Carlo Bielsa. Before we start, I would like to remind all of you that there are electrical and electronics engineers who are juridically and technically qualified to design these systems. So I do not claim nor represent nor render such services because there are these proper building professionals and we are here only to discuss these systems in a classroom setting. So what is this electronic systems all about? These are components related with the electrical system, kaya siya tinawag na electrical auxiliary systems, no? Providing a supplementary or additional information or signal, and as part of its process, transforms the signal into another as to give a desired system response, no? So parang merong stimulus and merong reaction. So first of the many systems that we are going to discuss is the public address and background paging music, no, or the pipe in music or yung PA system. So, ano ba itong PA system na ito? So, minsan kapag ka nag-grocery kayo in the supermarket, no, meron kayong narinig na mga pipe-in music or yung jingle or yung music station ID nung supermarket na yon, no? And yung purpose kung bakit sila nagpapatugtog ng jingle nila, one, of course, for marketing, no, or commercial. And yung pangalawa, no, may engineering behind it, it is to suppress unwanted background noises, no? Kasi, di ba, air-conditioned itong mga supermarkets na ito usually, no? And in their mechanical system sa mga ducts, no, kasi bakal 'yon, nagba-vibrate, so merong hum na maririnig, no, or minsan yung sa electrical yung lighting, no, parang merong lighting static, may marinig kang unnoticeable, no, pero irritating, no, or tolerable naman siya, pero pagka na-expose ka kasi bilang isang tao, no, palagi 8 hours a day doon sa quality ng sound na yon, no, it becomes detrimental, no. So para ma-suppress yung low frequency na mga sounds na yon, no, low frequency and high frequency sounds, ginagamitan ng pipe-in music, no. So ito minsan yung narinig niyo na sample. Come on in. So, di ba habang nag-grocery kayo, narinig na yun? So, yun yung purpose nung music na yun kung bakit siya continuous or naka-loop yung pag-play. So, isa pang purpose nitong PA system, no? Kung sino man sa inyo yung nakasakay na or sumasakay sa ating mga public infra, yung ating train systems, LRT, MRT, no? Merong ganito.
Welcome to Light Rail Transit of Metro Manila. Paunahing pasakayin ng mga matatanda, buntis, may kasamang bata at PWD. Kung sa tingin mo'y kabilang ka sa mga nabanggit, ano pang hinihintay mo? Dalian mo na. Kung sa iyong kalagay ay puno na ang tren, huwag mo nang ipagsiksikan ng iyong sarili.
no? So ginagamit nila yung music na yon or yung paging music na yon to announce, no, sa mga tao na paparating na yung train sa susunod na estasyon or kung meron mang important announcement yung operator ng train. So ayun, yung pangalawang system na i-discuss natin, ito naman yung biometrics and security system, no? So ano itong system na ito, no? So this depends on the level of security, no, or identification ng isang company, no, or ng building, no? Kasi pwedeng yung component, no, iris scanner, no, so sa mata yung pag-scan, pwedeng fingerprint, no, parang sa biometrics pag time in time out, no, so ginagamit ito pang sa HR, or pwedeng voice command or voice recognition, no, so maraming technology. So why do they employ this type of scanning or recognition system, no, for security? Because some of the tools, no, or yung mga rooms, no, they store confidential or private documents or information na pili lang yung makaka-access doon sa information na iyon, no? So parang ito yung sample nung isang security system. So if you're familiar with the film na Mission Impossible, no? So ginagamit nila minsan, no, fingerprint, no, may iris scan pa.
Good evening, Mr. Hunt. The weapons you recovered in Belarus were confirmed to be VX nerve gas, capable of...
So, ayun, confidential yung information, no, or yung message, laman ng message, kaya ginamitan siya nung biometric scanning, no, using the fingerprint. So, another example netong auxiliary system pa natin, no? Ito yung fire alarm and control system. Actually, isa lang ito, no? Yung fire detection and alarm system, no? But inhiwalay ko siya, no? Let's focus dito sa fire alarm and control. Ano ba itong fire alarm and control system na ito, no? So it has two types, no? Either conventional or the fully addressable type na system. And it depends, no, kung anong system yung gagamitin, depends yung mga components that will be involved, no. Pero ano-ano yung mga components na ito? So isa na dito yung annunciator, no, ito yung fire alarm annunciator. So it indicates kung nasaan yung emergency, no, saan na-detect yung emergency. So it alarms, no, yung isang area. And then yung ano, pull station, so ito yon. So pag merong isang tao nakakita na merong potential danger, no, or nakakita na magkakasunog, no, so manually ino-operate, no, manual pull station. So iba pang example yung strobe light, no, para sa mga hindi masyadong makarinig, may strobe light. Para sa mga iba naman, no, meron yung fire horn, no, or yung gong. Meron din yung lighting indicator at meron din yung fireman's jack, no. So ito yung mga components in this fire alarm and control system, no. Let's watch this video kung how this system, how these components, no, work in a building. So this is the sample.
Thank you. An incident has been reported in the building. Please await further instructions.
Achtung, im Gebäude ist eine Gefahrensituation gemeldet worden.
Dies ist ein Feueralarm. Bitte verlassen Sie das Gebäude umgehend über die nächste.
So, ayun, nakita nyo, no, kung it alarms a certain area, no? So, ito pa yung ibang components niya ng fire alarm system. Ito yung strobe light. Ito yung sa pool station naman, no? So, nakita nyo, no? Napanood, narinig nyo na nag-signal na merong emergency, no, merong hazard. Ito naman yung counterpart, no, nung system na ito, yung fire detection, no. Kung yung kanina pwedeng may manual control, ito automatic, no, na de-detect, no, na merong potential cause, no. Na-anticipate niya na kaagad, no? So, ano itong mga equipment na ito? So, pwedeng yung gas detector, no? Kapag sa mga rooms, no, na sobra na yung quantity, yung volume ng gas in the air, no? Heat detector para sa mga electrical rooms, no? Kasi, di ba, nauna muna in the fire triangle, nauna muna yung heat, no, bago yung fire, no. So pagka excessive na yung heat in that room, no, bago pa man na mag-generate ng fire, so nag-send na ng signal, no, papunta doon sa FACP panel, no, or yung fire alarm and control panel, no. So parang ganito, so may smoke. So it depends, no, kung anong equipment yung ipo-provide for a room, no, or for a building. So let's watch this, no. Ito yung terminal na pinupuntahan nitong dalawang signal na ito, no. Either yung signal kung manggaling sa fire alarm and control system or kung manggaling man sa fire detection system, no. So ang pupuntahang terminal nan nung information is the fire alarm control panel, no. So ito yung sample video ng fire alarm control panel.
Kung saan dito mo makikita, guys, yung ano, yung may problema na devices, para mabilis mo hanapin kung saan location ang may problema.
So, isa pa.
Ayun, mate, nag-tick. Okay? Ayun. Gumagana ang smoke detector. Then, reset. Okay? Umilaw doon. So, pag switch mo, soft touch switch, tick. Ganun, ha? Then, switch mo ulit. So, two. Ito yung heat detector. Pakinggan mo muna. Ayun, then switch ulit. Ayun, gumagana. Gumagana yung heat detector. Okay, reset.
Okay. So, ito yung sample ng fire control FACP, no? So, nadidetect, no, per zone kung nasaan yung potential threat or potential danger, no, magno-notify doon sa FACP, no, and pwedeng i-check ng kasi nasa BMS room ito, no, or nasa Fire Command Center, pwedeng i-check nung BMS manager or ng building administrator or ng security kung ano yung pinanggagalingan or meron ba talaga danger, no? So nandito rin sa FACP madidetect kung anong equipment, anong device yung nag-send ng signal, no? Pwedeng ang nag-send ng signal ay yung manual pull station. So ibig sabihin, merong taong nakakita, no? Kaya pinul niya yung lever dun sa pull station, no? Or baka nagiinit na yung electrical room, no? So nag-send ng signal yung heat detector, no, doon sa isang zone, no, ng electrical room, no. So ayun yung basic operation, no, or overview nitong FACP, no. Ito yung main terminal nung fire alarm and control and nung fire detection and alarm systems. So next, no, yung telecommunication systems. So ito ay connected sa telephone, no, and intercom. So let's watch this small short video clip.
A PBX, or private branch exchange, is the part of a private telephone system that manages phone calls both internally and externally for an organization. The PBX was developed to provide large companies a cost reduction in their telecommunications bill by letting them handle their own telephone system routing while still providing a telephone line for calling outside the company's network to the Public Switched Telephone Network, or PSTN. A PBX can be located on-premise, in the cloud, or through a hybrid of the two. Generally speaking, cloud-based systems are no longer referred to as a PBX, but as a Unified Communication, UC, solution, or UC as a service, UCaaS. From the technology perspective, there are four different types of phones or endpoints on a PBX: analog, digital, voice over IP, and session-initiated protocol, or SIP. A PBX takes one or more of these languages and translates it so that the PSTN can understand and connect calls. To get to the PSTN, a PBX must use either a telecommunication service provider, TSP, or an internet service provider, ISP, such as AT&T, CenturyLink, Sprint, etc. The PBX reduces costs by sharing trunk lines between multiple stations. Instead of subscribing to 100 trunk lines for 100 stations, a PBX delivers multiple stations for only one trunk line. Maintaining and updating an organization's PBX is an important part of keeping an organization connected.
So merong PBX, no, yung private branch exchange, no. So ito yung manual at yung isa naman, yung automatic, yun naman yung PABX, no. The private automatic branch exchange, no. So same lang yung function nila, no? So kaya kung mapapansin nyo sa isang company, no? So kunyari sa isang ospital, no? So sa ospital maraming department, no? Maraming institute na pwede mong tawagan, no? Kunyari tatawag ka sa ENT, sa OPTA, no? Or tatawag ka sa surgery ward, no? So instead na magkaroon ng separate line, no, separate na telephone line, no, alangan naman kung kunyari merong 50 na department yung isang ospital, no, alangan naman yung 50 na department na yon, iba-iba yung number nila, no. So meron lang isang trunk line, no, para doon sa hospital, and then nagkakaroon na ng mga tinatawag ng mga local numbers or mga extension, no? At usually meron yan yung sa operator, no? Like this. So yun yung ginagawa ng PABX, no? So minimize niya yung number, no, of private na private and individual na separate lines, no? And minsan, no? So ano yung usual na kilalang-kilala natin, no, na nagbibigay sa atin itong telephone line nito, si PLDT, no? Pero meron din na iba ngayon, si Payantel, no? So ang pinakasikat sa atin is si PLDT, no? And kasama minsan ni PLDT, meron na rin kasamang internet, no? So yun yung next nating i-discuss, no, yung internet. Kasi yung internet pwedeng kasama nga siya ng telephone, pwedeng individual siya or kasama siya ng network, no, ng sa mga cellphone, or pwedeng yung internet kasama ng cable TV network provider, no? So it depends, kasi si sa example si Sky, no, nagbibigay na rin siya ng internet niya, no, ng internet connection. So sa internet, ano yung mga components, no, na kasama dito? So nandito yung modem, no, or yung modulator, demodulator. Nandito yung of course yung router. And repeater or signal booster, and yung satellite dish, no, or kung minsan papunta sa MDF, no, kasama, kung kasama ng telephone company yan, no, papunta rin yan doon sa MDF na terminal, the main distribution frame. So isa pang auxiliary system natin, no, so pwedeng naka-separate, no, ito yung cable TV, no. So ano yung components? So yung wire, syempre, no, na nandun sa TV, and then yung outlet, no, na pagsasaksakan ng TV, and yung TV network or yung cable network na terminal, no. So minsan gumagamit sila ng satellite dish, no, para magbato ng information. And yung panghuli, no, babalik tayo doon sa biometrics and security, kasi isasama natin doon at pwedeng isama yung CCTV system, no. So ano yung system na yon? Minsan pinagko-connect sila nung sa biometrics, no. So merong camera at merong storage system, no, para ma-monitor of course yung environment, no, kung saan nakatutok yung camera. So ayun yung some of the electrical auxiliary systems. In our upcoming synchronous class, we will discuss salient provisions of the National Fire Protection Association and yung sa ating fire code, no? Because we need to correlate, no, our systems with our building codes, no, with the applicable building codes, no? So that's all. Thank you for listening, and see you again in the next lecture.